Welcome to the Spirit of Life channel. This message begin right now. The cosmic womb of the Divine Mother Goddess. Beloved Masters, many of you have asked, why is it that so few of the feminine archangels, avatars, masters, and ancient, wise ones communicate with us and give us guidance? As you are aware, those of the angelic realms are androgynous and carry all the attributes, qualities, and aspects of both our Mother/Father God. However, they do have preferences and, just as you, they often emphasize the attributes and qualities of either our Father or our Mother God. This is especially true of the archangels, and through the wisdom teachings down through the ages, you have learned the names of many of the most predominant masculine and feminine archangels whose main focus is this galaxy, solar system, the Earth, and humanity. Hopefully, you have become familiar with the particular ray each one radiates throughout this universe, the refracted attributes and qualities of Creator Consciousness, and you have studied the positive and negative qualities of each ray in order to assist you in returning to balance and harmony within your own radiant force field. When this young universe was created so many eons ago, the radiance of both our Father and Mother God burst forth in equal measure, and they were equal partners in the creative process. Our Father God, the masculine essence of the Creator, brought forth the seeds of new creation within his mind, resulting in a divine blueprint which was enfolded within the love core/emotional nature, or the cosmic womb of the Mother Goddess. Love Supreme radiated throughout the universe as the essence of creation from our Mother/Father God burst forth, and with the assistance of the Elohim, the great refracted beings of light who bear the mind nature of our Father God, and the archangelic realm, who are the primary bearers of the love nature of our Mother Goddess. Visions and miracles without end were manifested, and the multi-dimensions of creation were sent forth out into the great void. The saying, as above, so below, always applies, and just as surely as you came forth into the world from the cradling warmth of your mother's womb, so did we all burst forth as divine sparks of Creator light from the womb of our Divine Mother/God into our individualized consciousness. Spiritual expressions of such great and complex variety as to be beyond comprehension. The focus for many, many thousand years of your time has been on God as the Father, and humanity has sought to embody His dominant virtues and attributes, power, will, truth and valor, and the desire to create anew. It has been a patriarchal world and the Creator has been envisioned and acknowledged in only the male aspect of its greatness. The broad spectrum of duality/negativity that is now prevalent on Earth was predominantly created through the misuse of masculine energy. We do not mean to imply that the present male population is solely responsible for the negative environment in the world, for that is not the case. Remember, each of you has had many lifetimes in both the masculine and feminine body, and all have participated in the miscreations humanity is now endeavoring to rectify. There have also been many eras in your ancient past when the aspects of the Mother Creator were the predominant energy and focal point of worship. Just as you are bringing together all the parts of your vaster being, it is time to reunite and acknowledge the wholeness, as well as the many expressions of the Creator. The Goddess aspect, the Mother God, or the feminine energy of the Creator, is radiating more of her attributes and energy throughout the universe at this time. The attributes of divine love, compassion, illumination, nurturance, gratitude, faith, creativity, and the inner focus and awareness of spirit. These blessed energies will enhance, refine, and complement the masculine aspects of the Creator, divine will to create, wisdom, truth, valor, decisiveness and power, and they have always been and always will be available to you. Yes, the Blessed Lady Mary is very present and is always radiating the loving, compassionate energy of the Divine Mother to humanity. She is a great archangel and radiates the wondrous attributes of the fifth ray, scientific knowledge, unselfishness, the listening vocations and healing, along with the beloved A.A. Raphael. These two shining beings are assisting in the healing of the earth and humanity. As we have told you, this beautiful shining being, Mary, was designated as the feminine guardian overseer for this universal experience. Just as I, Michael, was given the honor of being the masculine guardian protector. There are also a few other beautiful female representatives who have come forth with wisdom teachings, and who have had a profound influence on humanity. However, as you are aware, the wisdom teachings and guidance in your recent historical times have been predominantly of a masculine nature, and there is a reason why this has been so. A great cycle of new creation is underway in this universe, and we have told you how the adamantine particles of Creator Light are permeating this universe on a luminous path of light. A portion of this light is being sent to the great cities of light station throughout the universe and, thereby, made available to any soul who has the ability to tap into the vibrations of the lower fifth dimension. We have explained this in great detail, and will not elaborate further at this time. What we have not explained is that the greater portion of Creator Light, or adamantine particles, has been designated for the creation of the new golden galaxy we told you about some time ago. Several hundred years ago, the Divine Mother called forth the members of the Order of the Goddess, the many facets of the feminine creator, to prepare themselves for a new birthing. These beautiful ladies of the light came forth from the far reaches of the universe and, together, through the radiance of their love nature, they began to build a vast cosmic womb of new creation in preparation for the forthcoming great expansion of the universe and the new golden galaxy. Yes, they are still aware of each of you, beloveds, and can radiate their loving energy to you and attend you each and every moment. However, their major focus is on radiating the loving essence of the Mother Goddess into the cosmic womb in order to prepare the adamantine particles for the seed thoughts/divine blueprint of the Supreme Creator via our Universal Father God. Therefore, the task of bringing forth the wisdom teachings of the New Age has been relegated, for the most part, to the masculine emissaries of light under the direction of our Father/Mother God. Have we not told you that these are unprecedented times? This universe is being bombarded by a mega cycle of light impulses, called adamantine particles, directly from the heart of the Supreme Creator. You see, it is a time for reunification at all levels, from the highest to the lowest. Therefore, the attributes, aspects and virtues of the Mother Creator will be the dominant force in the universe until balance is attained once more. Our omnipotent Mother can focus on every aspect of creation at once. So be assured that she is aware of everything that happens in her universe, and she never ceases to radiate her unconditional love to you. Remember, your DNA is encoded with divine love, compassion, and creativity, as well as the strength, power, and the will to create, which were passed on to each of us by our spiritual godparents. It is now time to integrate and claim all the blessings and gifts they have endowed you with. The strongest force in the omniverse is the love force, which is radiated through the essence of the goddess energy of the Creator. However, the light cannot begin to infiltrate the static or jumbled frequencies that make up the third/fourth dimensional physical vessel without the permission of the recipient and an opening of the sacred heart center. Your soul self, higher self, and God self are just waiting for a signal from you to begin the process, to open the light line of eternal life. Your DNA is filled with light, and every atom of your body is filled with light to one degree or another. If it were not so, you could not exist. It is time to unlock the flow of God light from within and from without, and it is imperative that you remove the filters from your eyes and your mind. As you are aware, each dimensional environment resonates to a specific range of frequency patterns, with each higher dimension vibrating within a higher and more refined range. As you made your journey into outer space and into the slow frequency patterns of the lower dimensions, each level resulted in a separation of consciousness from your higher self to some degree. In other words, within your brain structure and your mental body, the frequency patterns for each level of consciousness, or dimension, were stored in what we have termed light packets of wisdom. These were encased in membranes of light which restricted access to the various higher dimensional consciousness levels until you were, once again, resonating to that level of consciousness. The same process was used to isolate the strands of your DNA which contain the totality of who you are in a material sense, as well as your lineage and divine heritage. As you descended into the lower levels of consciousness, two by two, the DNA strands were encased in these membranes of light and, as a result, most humans have access to only two strands of DNA encodings. We have explained the process of how, as you gradually lift your consciousness and return to balance and harmony within your physical, mental, emotional, and etheric bodies, the membranes of light around your DNA strands and within your brain structure are slowly dissolved, giving you access to greater and greater levels of cosmic consciousness. You have read in many of the ancient teachings how a veil of forgetfulness was placed over your memory as you sank into the density of the lower dimensional worlds. This was not a punishment, but a necessary component in the process of refracting or decreasing yourselves into smaller and smaller sparks of consciousness. The term veil is not really accurate, however, it was the simplest term we could use to convey the concept to the masses before the Great Awakening began to take place. You see, it is all about conscious awareness of self, for how could you experience diminished capacity if you retained your skills and total recall of who you are and your origins? Also, how could you journey forth into the great void, leaving the purity and perfection of the source, without experiencing a fragmentation of self, which resulted in diminished capacity? And so you see, the veils are not really out there, but were formed within your own being. It is up to you and you alone to dissolve the veils of consciousness within so that you, once again, have access to your true identity as a self-master. Ascension is about ascending in consciousness, and reclaiming the vastness of who you are as you traverse the return path of illumination. You have been told that more and more of the children now being born are very old souls from far distance universes or star systems, and they are incarnating with more strands of DNA available to them and, also at varying degrees, they have higher levels of cosmic consciousness available to them within their brain structure. It is important for you to understand that the rules have changed as the process of evolution spirals to the next level. Each generation of souls for the past 100 years or so have incarnated with more of their cosmic memory available to them. In other words, the veil of forgetfulness is thinning and is slowly being eliminated altogether. The evolutionary process for humanity is in full swing and moving forward at an astounding pace. Open your minds and your hearts, beloveds, and embrace the infusion of divine love/light that awaits you. Bask in the glory of reunion with us as we move forward together on this incredible journey into a new reality. We are with you always and you are loved most profoundly. I am Archangel Michael.